This is definitely, to me, the craziest neighborhood in the country, as far as Canada goes. Especially the events that took place here. Like, I've never seen it happen anywhere else in Canada on that magnitude of like, violence. Just like publicity, negative publicity and shit that we've got. And that's nothing to be proud of, but just say, oh, we're the baddest neighborhood in the country, but that's just what it was. As far as you can Google Galloway and see like where we come from, what's happened there, you know?
So many niggas used to stand up there in the nighttime shit, just so that when the police were driving by on Kingston Road, you couldn't see them. And they were hustling, looking for the fiends walking by up and down. A lot of prostitutes and fiends and shit walking up and down this strip right here. Because before they built all these townhouses and shit, there was a lot of motels, a lot of shit that brought a lot of crackheads through. So they used to just stay out here all night and wait for who to walk by and whatever. And if you stood right in there, police really couldn't see you no matter how slow they were going, because all the branches and shit were like camouflaged. So I remember they came through one day and just chopped this whole bitch down. That's why you don't see no branches no more, so that they can see anybody out here. It's what we call front page. This is the front road of this shit. Kingston Road, you know? Kingston Road, Kingston, Galloway, G-Way, you already know. I don't remember his name, but this is definitely one of the top buckets. How you, man? You remember me? Dave Dollars, man. I used to call myself Dave. I was Dave back in the day when I was hustling shit. One of the best buckets. Shout out to him. He's still around and living. This is a great man right here. Yeah. Shit was always going on outside here. Everybody was always out here hustling, doing what the fuck ever it was. You know, and then it's like, when so much niggas are hustling in one little neighborhood, that breeds violence. Violence breeds police. So they build a multi-million dollar facility around the corner. You know, one of the top police stations in the city, and shut this whole shit down, and this is what happens. You don't see nobody outside. Everybody's in jail. And this is what's left.
I got cousins that still call me like, you rap? The fuck you rap? And you rapping on some G shit? Like, but you guys have polar bears and penguins, igloos, what the fuck you rapping about? Real shit. Like, I have some dumb ass cousins that still believe we have penguins in Canada. They don't know that there's real things going on over here like anywhere else in the world. I'm sure there's real things that go on in Paris. There's real shit that's going on anywhere in the world. So you can't have that closed-minded mentality and be ignorant to think that real shit doesn't go on everywhere.
So what, you think that perception of Canada is going to make it hard for you?
I think it will, but I'm not scared to tell where I'm from because we know it's real. I know everybody around me knows it's real. If you come to Toronto, a lot of rappers and shit that act as well, because everybody that comes out here that fucks with me knows it's real. They see what it is. So I don't really have nothing to prove as far as that, but as far as people gravitating towards the music, I think it'll be a little difficult for kids like in Chicago and shit, going through some real shit to believe that we are too. There's people in way worse conditions and way worse backgrounds that have done shit. Like, I just watched a documentary on Bob Marley the other day, and he came from fucking sometimes not even having shit to eat. I never had that problem. You know what I mean? Look at where he took it to. So not that I'm necessarily surprised, only because, you know, I grew up with a mother that always pushed me and always made me believe. I knew what hard work would get me. So I'm just surprised for the fact that, fuck, we lasted so long. Cause I could be in jail right now with a lot of my niggas right now that call me every day doing all kind of time right now, just for dumb shit that we did back in the day. So I'm surprised for a lot of things that I got lucky to make it through, as far as not being caught, you know?
You regret that cocaine charge?
I mean, $10 an hour to telemarketing job wasn't cutting it. I did what I had to do, so at the end of the day, I don't regret anything that I did. I regret it because I can't cross the border, obviously, but I don't regret it because at the end of the day, I had fucking Pampers to buy, you know what I'm saying? So that's just what it was. I regret getting caught. Shit.
What about the gun charge?
What gun charge?
Everybody's been waiting on your mixtape, Dear America. What's taking so long?
We can't travel a lot. I mean, I kind of sat down and depended on a lot of other people around me instead of just doing my own thing and putting out music when I should have been putting out music. I was waiting on a lot of people around me and a lot of things that I thought would have helped push my career further than it did. And I really thought I would have been across the border a lot quicker than this. I didn't want to waste the music and just put it out there and not be able to go shake hands and touch and meet people across that border. So I waited on a lot of shit that kind of fucked me over as far as talent-wise, but we're still here now, so.
What's to be said about your production team and, I mean, the chemistry you have with guys like Prologic?
Prologic's been like a God blessing. That's my engineer, that's my main producer. Niggas don't realize, like, an engineer will fuck your whole shit up. Until I met Pro, I never knew what a good engineer was. And production-wise, I mean, once you get in a groove with somebody that's helping to shape your sound, and you feel comfortable with that person, just leaving at night and come back the next day and knowing that your shit will sound that much better. I've been in Boy Wonder's basement before, you know, he made his big record. I've been in Drake's basement before he made his big record. So I know it's something that is easy to be accomplished. I see where they came from. And to find somebody that is on that same level as far as Pro Logic, Baseline, some Bimo, and a lot of dudes that I'm working with, it's like it's really a blessing because I can compete. Everybody's a fucking rapper or a singer or a reggae artist or some shit now. Now that fucking Drake popped, fucked the whole shit up. It's crazy, but it's cool. I'd rather be like that than nobody popped at all and everybody's hating on everybody still. I mean, people are trying to, we call it the screw face capital because everybody hates on everybody. But I think now that a nigga or two made it, everybody's starting to show everybody a little bit more love because everybody has their own dreams. Their inner children is coming out of everybody. Everybody wants to be some kind of fucking musician now and shit. Cool, fuck. First real video was, I think you know I'm fly. We had a free Gilla t-shirt to the end. My little brother's in jail shit. Then it was probably, what? Money in my pocket, and in my hood, didn't call my name. Everybody's like, you can shoot every video in your neighborhood. I think I'm just so proud of where I'm from, and I like the love I get here, especially when I come back.
In her robe? Not in her robe.
What the hell?
You have to
visit a role. I'm not in the ghetto in my role. Right. I know that's great. And I'm glad he's back.
The look on her face. I think that's just crazy. Like, that was more of an accomplishment for me than anything. And I just wanted to keep recreating that feeling, I think. In my hood, we had no permit. We tried to shoot on the north side. They shut that down. Like 100 cops, they shut that right the fuck down. We had to go to another hood, like 10 minutes up the street and finish that video. That's where Drake pulled up in the Maybach. I wasn't even in the hood. That was like Pitfield. Like, they're Scarborough town and shit. Another little neighborhood we fuck with. Because the police shut this shit down. Everything, they ripped these posters off the walls of corner stores.
This is that Canadian Dream mixtape, my first real solo mixtape. I was like Super Canada Man back then and shit. This was really just a poster. We were planning on doing a mixtape, but it was really just to promote us as a crew. It's Gilla. That's me, that's Chubbs, you know, fat nigga that's on tour with Drake.
That's
Purple Bandit. I don't know what he didn't even really rap. I don't know what the fuck he was. He was kind of like the mascot.
I'm the guy.
We used to put these in the stores across the streets and shit, and this shit would actually sell. Niggas would come to high school, buy this for like $5, $10 a pop. Yeah. We'd give the Chinese lady like
$3. What year was that?
And then it got to a point where the police would start going in there and actually seeing that we're making a little bit of money. Putting the posters off the walls, telling the Chinese lady she couldn't sell CDs. So when we would go back to her, she'd be like, yo, I'm out of CDs. I need more CDs. I'm like, fuck, this shit is selling. Re-up the Chinese lady. Then one day she's like, no, can't take no more. She told us the story about the police. We're like, man, they're gonna keep fucking with you, so we'll sell the shit ourselves.
America's such a fucking dream right now. It seems like it's not even nothing crazy too, because you hear about niggas driving across the border just to go to Buffalo with a girl or some shit for the day. But it seems like it's so far away, and it's such a dream out of grasp of reality right now that Instagram's a motherfucker too, because you'll see a nigga with some pictures and some videos and shit. A party in Miami. Never been to Miami. Never been to LA. I don't even know what these places
look
like. Palm trees in the
state. Never been to Miami.
Mind blowing to me. Never been to Miami. Never been to LA. A lot of my niggas fucking still call me and all the crazy shit that they're doing. They'll send pictures, text me pictures and shit, and be like, oh fuck, nigga, you missed last night and all the crazy shit that's going on. And niggas get blocked. Niggas still send me pictures, they get blocked. I told them that if you call my phone in America, it's one word in that fucking sentence, doubt them. I just want to hear about this shit. It seems like a dream. I wake up sometimes in cold sweats. I'm just in LA and shit. It's fucked up. I'm being real as fuck too.